We are going viral. Texans scorner Jonathan Joseph called T.Y. Hilton a clown ahead of their wild card matchup, so T.Y. showed up in the appropriate attire and got the last laugh, waking up after the Colts win to his daughter.
Savage.
I mean, that'd be scary, man. If you really woke up to that, you wake up, first thing you see is, was that it?
A lot of people terrified by those clown masks and everything.
Apparently, the DBs from the Texans were terrified of T.Y. Hilton.
First drive, 3 catches, 63 yards on that first drive of the game.
Not a lot of resistance from that Texans defensive backfield.
Yeah, they looked like they were aging like Benjamin Buttons going the other way.
I didn't get a lot right this weekend. This game I nailed. Now, after this game, Nick's picks went downhill a bit.
Back but that game I nailed. Taking on the Bears, fourth quarter, Philly down 5. Nick Foles finds Golden Tate in the end zone to put Philly up 1. Bears would have a shot to win this one. Here's Cody Parkey. He had just made one, but the Eagles iced him, and he doink and doinks it. Ball bounces the wrong way from the 43-yard.
Double doink, Jenna.
Eagles win. Foles wins. Nick Foles has somehow, some way, now won his last 4 playoff starts. Here he is after the game. Double doink.
I draw my strength from, you know, those guys in the huddle, just look in their eyes, the belief they have, not only in me, but in one another. And knowing that, you know, this was a crazy game. There's a lot of adversity. I mean, this is one of the most hostile environments I've played in. You know, their fans came out, and, you know, we still had a lot of support here, too. But it was, you know, I'll sleep well tonight for sure.
All right, Chris Canty, you can't ignore the fact that this team keeps on winning with Nick Foles. Whether he helps them win or not, he's there when they do win. What do you think Nick Foles has to do to convince the Eagles that maybe he should be their guy moving forward?
Well, I know a lot of this talk picked up once the Eagles got into the postseason. Chicago Bears in Week 17 beat the Minnesota Vikings, and then the Eagles took care of their business against the Redskins. At that moment, everybody started talking. Maybe Nick Foles needs to be the quarterback for this team moving forward. CC, you and I see this one the same way. The organization has a lot invested in Carson Wentz. He was playing at an MVP level last year before he got hurt with the torn ACL. But Nick Foles goes on that magical run, and the team played well. One of the best teams in terms of depth from a season ago. Hadn't played so well, hadn't been consistent this year, but right. Then Nick Foles steps in, and he's the starting quarterback, and the team responds, and they played well down the stretch, and they executed yesterday when it mattered the most. They were able to get the win on the road. I look at this situation with Nick Foles, and I say, if he wins another playoff game, especially what they have coming up going down in New Orleans, then it becomes a real discussion in the front office with Howie Roseman and the Eagles personnel staff. When you look at that matchup during the regular season in Week 11, they got beat to sleep by the Saints. They lost 48-7. If he's able to take, by and large, the same cast of characters down in New Orleans.
Regardless of how he plays, Kenny?
Regardless of how he plays and beats Drew Brees, who has never lost in a playoff game in the Superdome.
Right.
If he's able to pull that one off, then I think you have to have a legitimate conversation about trying to keep Nick Foles around next year. I know he's got a huge cap number, $20 million cap number. Carson Wentz has an $8 million cap number. I think it's a situation, if he wins another playoff game, they should consider keeping both, but it becomes a real discussion if he wins this coming weekend.
Well, I've been very consistent on this, and I know my partner Chris doesn't love hypotheticals, but we're going to have to play the hypothetical game here for a moment. To me, it's very simple. If they win the Super Bowl, there is no question whatsoever he is the starting quarterback next year, and you recoup some of that investment you put into Carson Wentz by getting a couple first-rounders for Carson Wentz, because he is you would get at least 2 first-rounders if he were available. If they get to the Super Bowl, I believe Nick Foles is the quarterback next year. Anything short of that, even beating New Orleans, but losing in the NFC Championship game, this remains Carson Wentz's team. But if he takes you, if Nick Foles, you get to and win the Super Bowl as a 1 seed, and then with nothing but home games, right? Nothing but underdogs, by the way, on the route there. And you play Tom Brady at least to a draw in that game your team ends up winning. And then get you to another Super Bowl as the 6th seed. A 9-7 team, 6th seed, underdogs in every game, road dogs in every game, and you get back to a Super Bowl, he's the quarterback. You can't, I don't think it's going to happen. Now, I didn't think they were going to beat the Bears.
You didn't think they were going to win this week.
And I think 9-point dogs this next week. If they beat the Saints and then go on the road to either Dallas or the Rams and win that game, you can't not have the guy who's taking you to back-to-back Super Bowls be your quarterback the next year. You just can't.
Well, you can. It's just in your world, you don't think you can. And the reason why you can do it is, it's still about the best player. And those guys in the locker room, forget what we're talking about, they know which guy is the best player. So even if Nick Foles goes to the Super Bowl, being like, ah, Chris, you told me if you get more information, you'll be willing to change your mind. I'm going to give you your hypothetical situation. He wins the Super Bowl. Okay. And you know what I do? I recoup some of those picks, and I ship him out of town. Because if he does
Nick Foles out of town.
Yes.
Nick Foles, okay.
Yes, absolutely. I get you what you want. I get you some of those picks, and I go with the quarterback that's got the lower cap number and has got a higher ceiling. So if Nick Foles has won you two Super Bowls, let me tell you something. He's tapped out. You think he's going to win a third one? Oh, no, no, no. So I'm going to keep Carson Wentz because I've won two. My chances of winning another one around this stud at quarterback, they're much better than going with Nick Foles into the future because Nick Foles deserves the right to be named this. He's the best backup we have in the NFL, and he deserves to be a starter. He deserves to have his own team, but that team won't be the Philadelphia Eagles. So even if he gets Super Bowl number two, that will be the only two in history of the I'll trade. Yes, that's what I'll do. Wow. Because in the locker room, the players know who's better.
Do you agree with that last point Chris is making, that if they win the Super Bowl, the players in the locker room would still think we should go with Carson Wentz? If they win the Super Bowl, because you're saying it doesn't matter what we think, which is correct to a degree, but that if they were to win the Super Bowl, you don't think if there was a straw poll amongst the players, if we can only keep one, do you think the players would say keep Wentz over Foles? Because I don't.
I think you'd have guys on both sides of that argument because confidence comes from demonstrated performance. You've heard me say that before. And if Nick Foles demonstrates that he can do it not once but twice, and this time with a higher degree of difficulty because they're going on the road, then I think that's not only a conversation that's happening up top or upstairs.
So tell me something. The guy who tips the kick right there at the end, he think it was Nick Foles, or he think that any quarterback could have won this game? Jason Peters was dominant.
Yeah.
My man Lane was dominant. They think it's the quarterback? They only scored 16 points.
No,
I'm with you on this Carson Wentz thing. I believe that Carson Wentz is the better player.
When we are in practice, we see which guys are better. And a lot of times, man, we get so upset when a coach is playing a guy for some other reason besides the talent. Carson Wentz has shown us, all right? They need to support. If the team plays the same way, they're such a better team.
But the one thing I will say to push back, CC, Carson Wentz has shown us that he is a more talented player, but Carson Wentz has also shown us he is a more injury-prone player. And the best ability is availability. He had the torn ACL last year. He's got a broken vertebrae.
Right, no problem. If you guys want to argue
so
that,
my whole thing is this. If Nick Foles continues to play well and they win a couple of more playoff games, then as an organization, I would consider keeping both of those guys in-house.
I think your plan is a good one.
I think
based
that's exactly what you would
because
do.
Because you're talking $28 million for your quarterback position isn't egregious compared. So that would be an option to him. To just activate that option, I think it would be, you would be putting Carson Wentz, again, in this scenario where they get to or win the Super Bowl, you'd be putting Carson Wentz in a weird spot where I think the fans of Philadelphia feel like
the fans are going to want
Nick would
Foles.
Want Nick Foles.
Yeah, so we heard the fans in Baltimore, so we're not listening to the fans on any quarterback.
Listen to the fans. You'd be sitting with the fans.
Yeah, Flacco won them a Super Bowl. Now all of a sudden they won. They forgot what happened 8 weeks ago.
It's totally fair, but you're right that Jason Peters doesn't think I play better because Nick Foles is out here. The tipped field goal that defensive lineman doesn't think he did this because Nick Foles is out there. But what they might think is, man, I know Nick Foles on fourth and goal with our season online can make that play. Haven't seen Carson Wentz do it yet. I know Nick Foles can go in a Super Bowl and have the moment not be too big for him.
The guys know it's a team. No one is thinking Nick Foles in that locker room is doing it. Everyone thinking, you know what I got to do today, Malcolm Jenkins? Man, I got to cover. Man, I got to get down the box. Man, I got to do my job better. All right? Nick Foles is who he is now. Let's not forget.
They
now,
did
let's
build
not
a shrine
trip.
To him in that locker room. Chris Long did. A shrine.
Yeah, anytime you know that a player, see, if you thought the player was better, you wouldn't have to build a shrine.
Yep.
They think it's magic.
Yeah.
Right?
Chris Canty, thank you so much for joining us. Much appreciated. Got to take a break. Coming up, how did the Chargers figure out how to stop Lamar Jackson? That is next on First Things First.